All righty, take a look at this. SkyCam 8 Santa Cruz. Folks coming down to the wharf, some for the ride, some for the show. Sorry, I put out some wrong information earlier this morning. It's the Spin Doctors. Smash Mouth, I do believe, is playing in Santa Cruz, though.
At the Catalyst.
There you go, at the Catalyst. That's why it was in my brain. So either way, should be a fun time. The free one is over at the boardwalk, though. 61 in Santa Cruz right now, 63 Hollister, 66 in King City. It's not going to be the warmest of days, but we are expecting a break back in some sunshine for a little while. Low clouds will be back in by 6 or 7 tonight, though, so bring the jacket. You can see we're still surrounded at the bay, and you can see the low clouds are just sort of wafting in on a light westerly breeze. There's almost no wind, actually, out across most sites right now, including out at the buoys. So very calm on the bay right now. 64 San Francisco, only 77 in Sacramento. That is something I'm sure they are loving, because it can get pretty hot in Sacramento this time of year. 104 Palm Springs, currently 96 Vegas, 76 Lake Tahoe, and only 68 down in San Diego. So there's not much beach weather for them either. If you do want to do some beach, some hot, South Texas would be a good spot. Anywhere along the Gulf Coast, 102 in Phoenix, they'll do the pool there, and 98 in St. Louis, at 91 Chicago, 77 New York City. So it is hot, and along with that heat, you combine the humidity, you have all kinds of advisors. These are excessive heat warnings, meaning more or less don't do anything outside if you don't have to. And then on the bottom and the perimeter, basically, you're looking at heat advisories, which means it's really hot and you should take it easy. And really that goes across a good chunk of the eastern half of the nation right now. That's one of the reasons we haven't been able to warm up. The big ridge of high pressure is out here. It hasn't moved at all, so their weather stays the same. So does ours. You got to get everything on the move for things to change. And you notice this is the remnants of Tropical Depression 5, actually just producing a lot of heavy rain down in the southeast. We also have showers and thunderstorms, a line of those coming through Chicago. So watch out. There could be some airport delays up at O'Hare this afternoon. Now, we're looking at the water vapor imagery, and we have low pressure here, low pressure out here, and a high pressure ridge is actually down out this way with the dry air. And unfortunately, it's going to move towards us, but probably not enough to either get a offshore flow or a lot of heat to the coast. Here's how it looks from Futurecast. This is how it looks right now. You can see the heat's way out in the deserts, but it is going to start to make its march towards us. We'll get hot in the Sierra. We'll be hot in the Central Valley. And even our local valleys will be pretty warm over the weekend into next week. But you can see the real heat stays out here. And with the sea breeze and the ocean influence right at the beach, not going to see a whole lot of warming. And it's certainly not going to be a heat wave. 62 San Francisco, 72 Mountain View. Still really nice inland, though, in both the Santa Clara and the Salinas Valley. They have middle and upper 70s to low to mid 80s. So it's certainly not too hot there. And they're only going to gain another 4 or 5 degrees through the weekend and into next week. So, again, this is not going to be any kind of a heat wave. 62 to about 65 between Marina and Carmel. I'm not figuring out a whole lot of sunshine on the peninsula. Just breaks. And we should get back to mostly sunny in Santa Cruz, 71, 68 for Watsonville, and 70s and low 80s up in the Santa Cruz Mountains. So over the weekend and into early next week, we do see some 90s inland, but those are the usual spots that would get them this time of year. And basically 70s and 80s through most of the Salinas Valley and the Santa Clara Valley. Now at the coast, it's not going to be nearly that warm, 65 to about 75, which puts us back to about average numbers. It'll probably feel warmer than it actually is indicating on the thermometer in terms of the seasonal norms, because we haven't really seen much in the way of 70s at all at the coast for a while. So that'll be kind of a welcome sight, and it looks like that could hold through about Tuesday next week.
We do like that.
Yeah.